Okay, yep, I've dry brushed this whole thing with Bolt Gun Metal now. And the book says now to highlight it with chainmail. But I don't do that because, to be honest, I find the whole highlighting thing annoying because it takes so long to do every single ridge that's above, I don't know, the waistline or whatever. So what I'm going to do is dry brush it with chainmail instead. It just makes things a lot quicker, but when you dry brush it with a chainmail, you need to just go around the edges of this bit, because otherwise it's just going to make the whole thing go chainmail. So yeah, just go around the edges of the thing and then dry brush everything else, including like the head and everything, pretty much everything that you've just dry brushed. Okay, so yeah, I'll just show you. Okay, so yeah, just go around the sides of this. It just around all the sides of it, and you will tell the difference. It just won't, at first it won't look like it, but it will. You will. Can't really see the difference, I don't think, but you will once you paint it. You will. Okay, it's all around the sides. Yeah, by the way, with this, when you just get some more paint and put it on, don't bother doing it again and again and again, because just waste your paint. Unless you really desperately need to, like this bit's all going to be all dry, just keep going around on that and it'll just put more paint on your brush. Saves paint and time, to be quite honest. So you wouldn't need to go out and keep buying more paint. Which is good, gives you more money to buy models. And so yeah, there's the top bit of it done. You can't really see it, but like, there's the thing, and then it does sort of look brighter. It's just the aim of it is to make it look brighter. So yeah, and then on the sides, you just have to go. Just like that. That's all it is. That's just the whole of the tail done just there. Well, the whole of the side of the tail. More paint. There we go. And just the chest plates. The underneath. Just do a quick bit underneath here, because that's going to be mainly shadow, so that can be darker. And the head. Yeah. And the claws and arms. And onto the gun and the other arm. Kind of makes it more of a solid colour as well. Some more paint. And then inside of the gun and the arm. Same with the other arm. Sorry, you can't see this very well. It's a bit complicated getting my paintbrush into it and being able to see it. Okay. So then it should end up like that. Okay. And then I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Okay, welcome to video 2. We're painting this Wraith to end up looking like this Wraith. Obviously with a different tail, but yeah, that's generally it. Yeah. So yeah, next step, we need... Obviously, if you don't have any of the Citadel washes, you don't have to use these colours, just a good black wash and a brown wash. These are my favourite ones. Well, for this step anyway. So yeah, let's grab these. Good shake. Nice big brush. I use a tank brush for the whole washing things, especially on big models, because it's just easier to get around and do it quickly instead of using a little brush and getting it and taking forever to do it. Yep. So get some... I get some black. Not much left. Okay, get some black. Get a quick wash, don't want to spread the colours into other paint pots. Excuse me. Oh yeah, by the way, you're probably noticing I've got my camera on a tripod. Yay! So yeah, now you can all see me better. Okay, and open it up. And put some brown into it. It should end up this colour. This is like dried old stuff. But yeah, you might need two lots. I put in two lots of brown, one lot of black. Because I think when Necrons get up into rain, they must rust because they're made out of metal. So yeah, I make it a more browny colour than a black colour, but it's still quite a dark colour. And then I wash it down because I don't want it to go right through and make the metal completely brown. So I put two drops of water in it. Okay. Actually, that might be a bit too much water, actually. Put some more brown in that. There you go. Okay. Then you need to grab your model. Just go everywhere with it. It makes it kind of looking old and brown and rusty. And obviously, if you want your Necrons to look brand new, you don't have to do this step. Just skip this bit. And then they can look brand new. And use a lot on this, on the top of it, because that's where, if it was to rain in battle, then that's the bit that it would hit first. On the top bit. So I put a whole bunch of ink on that one to make it look really rusted. And on the face, on the arms. The side of the tail. In the middle. Remember to get the end, because that end's going to be... Well, especially if you've got the wires, get all the end... If I can show you... At the end of here, it's got all, like, the, these bits. Like, at the ends of the wires. They need to do... You need to do the same things that you've done on those with what you've just done so far. So just go around everything and then just quickly do them. Doesn't have to be neat because you're going to paint over these wires. Okay? And then... Get the arm. And the gun. I think it's really cool how the gun's attached to their arm. So they can't drop their gun. It's just like, they want to run. They've got like, well, they can't really run. If they just want to, if we want to flee from battle, so they live, they're gonna have to carry this gun the whole way back, and it's... Imagine sleeping with it. But yeah, and then... Should end up just looking like that. Then you need to really let that dry, and give it a good half an hour to dry. And I'm gonna be back when that's dry, when mine's dry. But for you, that'll be 2 seconds. So, yeah, I'll see you in the next step. Bye!